one of the challenges of studying natural hazards is you don't get to control your experiments. You know, they just happen when they happen. I am Emily Brodsky. I am a geophysicist. Sometimes I think of myself as a geologist with a short attention span. I like earthquakes, a little bit of landslides, a little bit of glaciers, a little bit of volcanoes, and other things that fail catastrophically. You know, at this point in my career, I have just enough time to make one more really big thing happen. I want to know which of these phenomena are predictable, which ones are not, and what it's going to take. And to do that, you need long-term instrumentation there before the earthquake happens. As U.S. scientists, we're kind of morally obligated to learn things about hazards that are useful to U.S. citizens. There's significant risk in the Pacific Northwest, as well as Alaska. We expect someday a magnitude 9 earthquake. Scientifically, strategically, the best thing to do is to go to a sped-up version, learn what we can there, and then bring that information home. Chile is the Pacific Northwest on steroids. You get more earthquakes, more volcanic eruptions, more mass failure than anywhere else. The plan for SC4D is that we build a multi-array of instrumentation that spans from the volcanic mountains all the way out to the seafloor and can capture the system-level interaction between the hazards for a long time. My job is to train the next generation of scientists so that they really are multidisciplinary scientists. They think about the whole system and they're equipped to actually use this data properly. I don't think any of us are promising anybody that we're going to predict the next magnitude 8 earthquake, but we're going to do our best to learn whether or not there is even any hope any day of ever predicting a magnitude 8 earthquake.